Hoddle. Hoddle! It's there! It's there! Roberts, it was Hazel split, and Bennett was in there, and it's a goal!
Good evening from Wembley Stadium, where the 101st Football Association Cup Final has gone to a replay tonight between the holders Tottenham Hotspur and 2nd Division Queen's Park Rangers. And with the news of the Falklands Islands crisis dominating British thoughts, there's been no question of the Spurs manager Keith Birkinshaw playing the Argentinian Ricky Villa. But the news is that Villa is with the Spurs party in the stadium. And apart from the odd boo, received a most generous and remarkable reception when he walked on the pitch. Has been made welcome. His Argentinian nationality no barrier. His skill as a footballer recognised and saluted. But in a moment, there'll be the chance to assess the mood of this almost all Cockney crowd as they're invited to join in one of the great British traditions. The singing of the Cup Final hymn, Abide With Me, with the guest of honour, His Royal Highness, the Duke of Kent.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you all please stand to sing with the band the traditional Cup Final hymn, Abide With Me, the words of which are on page 3 of your programme. Ladies and gentlemen, Abide With Me.
Cup Final hymn, Abide With Me, sung with a new warmth and feeling. And so the stage set now for the match itself. And don't forget tonight, as well as covering the whole match live, we're awarding a special trophy for the man of the match chosen by you at home watching BBC television. The clear leader after the first match was the Rangers goalkeeper Peter Hucker. The votes, don't forget, are carried forward to be counted over the two matches. And the phone lines will be open for you to ring 15 minutes before the end of the match. The number to ring is 01, only if you're outside London, 01 if you're outside London, 811-8055, 811-8055. And the phone lines will be open 15 minutes before the end of the match. Our two experts tonight, the voice of BBC Football, Jimmy Hill, who will be in the commentary box with John Motson, and the popular Southampton manager, Laurie McManaman. But now, this vast crowd Nearly 200,000 people, in fact, have paid over £1.5 million to watch this final from the terraces. 100,000 on Saturday and over 90,000 tonight. And now, as the teams wait in the tunnel, we can join our match commentator, John Motson.
Yes, records abound at Wembley tonight. It's the latest time in the season that the FA Cup final has ever been settled, 5 days before the beginning of June. And taking up David Coleman's point about the receipts, counting other ancillary fees such as television rights and so on, this has become, thanks to the money these fans have paid in the main, the first £2 million cup final, when you bear in mind all the money that's changed hands. And if you're wondering where the money goes, well, of that £1.5 million in ticket money, Wembley Stadium themselves take 25% straight away. And the remainder is split four ways, £300,000 or thereabouts to each of the two clubs whose teams are now on their way. The rest of the money going to the Football Association and also to the 92 clubs from the Football League who took part in the FA Cup. And the two who are left, Tottenham Hotspur nearer the camera and Queen's Park Rangers on the far side. For Spurs, a sixth Wembley appearance in only 12 and a half months. But thanks to Peter Hucker, very largely, second division Queen's Park Rangers stayed in the match on Saturday and forced a replay tonight. To finish the season with a trophy, Tottenham, having at one time chased four targets. What spirit Queen's Park Rangers showed on Saturday, when it appeared that the Tottenham goal would beat them, they replied more or less straight away. Tony Curry is their captain tonight in the absence of the suspended Glenn Roeder. And the Duke of Kent, His Royal Highness, is the president of the Football Association. And standing in the tunnel, Ricky Villiard, who is a rival we covered earlier. Also Glenn Roeder. Duke of Kent, who will present the FA Cup to the winning captain tonight. And bear in mind, it has to be tonight, because if these two teams finish level again after extra time, it goes to penalties. And what an honour for Tony Curry, late in his career, to be leading his team in an FA Cup final at Wembley. Quite unexpected in a sense, but the enforced absence of Glenn Roeder forcing Rangers to change their formation and their captain. Gary Micklewhite, who you saw shake hands a moment ago, is the replacement for Clive Allen. That's the other change. Terry Venables, who felt tactically his side had a say on Saturday in that the goal came from a header at the far post, an area which they hoped to exploit in the Tottenham defence. The aerial view as the Duke of Kent goes across to have the Tottenham players presented to him. We've already seen Ricky Villar and Glenn Roeder, but another unlucky figure in this FA Cup final, Clive Allen, whose ankle injury sustained on Saturday rules him out tonight. Tottenham, in contrast, are unchanged. And we'll have a complete check for you on the two lineups after the presentations. The referee and linesman also unchanged. Clive White in the middle again tonight. Looks in good shape. There's two linesmen, Alex Hamill from Wolverhampton, Terry Mitchell from Bath. Seven out of seven, remember, Tottenham in FA Cup finals. The reserve official at the end of the line as well, Ray Guy. Ceremony over, and once more now we concentrate on the football. Queen's Park Rangers forced then into changes after Saturday. Roeder's suspension giving Curry the captaincy, and Terry Fenwick, despite keeping the number two shirt, the job at the centre of the defence alongside Bob Hazel, and 19-year-old Warren Neal, though wearing number six, will play at right back. Allen's injury means Gary Micklewhite wears number nine. He'll be on the right of a four-man midfield, and Mike Flanagan will play up front with Simon Stainrod. Substitute Steve Burke. Tottenham are able to field the same 12 for the replay, just as they did last year against Manchester City. Indeed, six of the Spurs side have played in all those six Wembley matches since last May. A few days' rest has obviously helped the injuries to Perryman, Galvin and Clements. So the man who leads at the moment in our viewers' poll for man of the match, and if it went to penalties tonight, then there would be a true test, as if he hasn't had one already, for Peter Hucker and indeed for Ray Clements. Steve Burke has been called in as the substitute. Terry Fenwick, the man whose goal forced this replay, has already put his name firmly in the record books. Not only the first fullback to score in open play in an FA Cup final at Wembley, but the first to do so this century. Although tonight, as I said, he won't be playing fullback. And Warren Neal at 19, the youngest player in the match. Although he has had some FA Cup experience this season, Rangers fans haven't forgotten that in the third round replay at Middlesbrough, he scored the winning goal in extra time. Steve Archibald, who must feel he's due a goal. He's also one of Spurs' nominated penalty takers, although he says he can't remember ever taking one before. And sometimes, although clubs start off naming five players for that eventuality, the way the game goes sometimes makes a difference. And of course, only players on the field at the time, at the end of extra time, can take penalties. So Ricky Villar has taken his seat, and in the replay last year, we all know what happened. Those two goals, the second one which won the cup for Tottenham, the cup that they defend tonight. The colours are unchanged, and there are some viewers who wondered why both teams have had to change. Well, in the normal strips of the two clubs, the FA decided there was too much white. Rangers blue and white hoops normally, Tottenham white shirts. So in the end, it was decided that both teams would change. So Spurs playing from the right in the first half. Start this FA Cup final replay, the second consecutive replay at Wembley. Here's Hazard. It's Micklewhite getting back to challenge him, and also Neil getting a first touch. And moving straight away into that right-back position. Fenwick, for the moment, is looking after Crooks. Roberts with the long throw. Bob Hazel is up there to clear for Rangers. Here's Flanagan, leaving it for Tony Curry. Breaking on the left is Gary Waddock, but it went right to Roberts of Spurs. Fenwick. Header back was by Price. Tony Galvin at outside left, number 9. And the block was by Micklewhite. Corner to Spurs. Played quickly to Mick Hazard. Here's Hoddle. Ian Gillard has come across to cover Galvin. Micklewhite will probably play just in front of Warren Neal, certainly early on, to give Rangers extra insurance against the thrusts down the Tottenham left of Galvin, who's so dangerous when he picks up pace. Micklewhite, the runner up front is Steinrod, the header by Price. Here comes Flanagan for Rangers. Price again. It was Gary Waddock who challenged Glenn Hoddle, and the foot was high. Referee signalled for a free kick. Flanagan looks for Steinrod. Perryman covering. Here's Archibald letting it run for Crooks. Archibald challenged by Curry, but not a good pass. Hazel battling it out. Went to Flanagan and on to Micklewhite. Roberts. Hazard, who set the move going, and Hoddle, who's pressed forward with the strikers as Galvin takes the ball down the left and ran it out. So the width on Tottenham's left, a point to bear in mind. Hoddle, this is Archibald, and Hazard spraying it out to Hoddle. Waddock in close attendance, and that's going to be a feature of the match again, no doubt. Terry Venables has told Gary Waddock to try to block Glenn Hoddle's path whenever possible. Graham Roberts with the throw for Tottenham. Bob Hazel's header, and then Garth Crooks. Tottenham's 66th match of the season, but Rangers themselves well into the 50s. John Gregory up, on to Flanagan. Micklewhite beaten by Miller. Houghton. Galgan's making his run, and Fennett coming across to cover behind the fullback, and a goal kick is given. Cool, almost sultry evening after the rain earlier in the day. Lyons is the referee, Stainrod. Roberts. Away from John Gregory, Graham Roberts. Archibald to his right, he overran it, but still got through. This is Graham Roberts, was he brought down? Penalty! Tony Curry came in behind him. Fenwick was in close attendance, but a penalty has been given, and it was a splendid run by Graham Roberts. Terry Venables' side couldn't stop him. Bob Hazel made an error in that early on, but Roberts went on. And what happens here? Tony Curry comes in with the tackle. Down he goes. Penalty. Hoddle to take. Scores. Never has a penalty been missed in an FA Cup final at Wembley. And Tony Curry gave that one away, the Rangers captain. And it was the Tottenham playmaker, Glenn Hoddle, who wasted no time in converting it. Not much emotion on the face of Keith Birkinshaw, but he could hardly have wished for a better start. What a tremendous run by Roberts, to give him full credit. He charged through the centre. Flanagan for Queen's Park Rangers. Trying to find Stainrod. And he has. Chris Houghton. So Spurs lead 1-0. Tony Curry, I wonder how that'll affect his game, if at all. Ironical, I suppose, that Curry should have unwittingly deflected Hoddle's shot on Saturday for the Tottenham goal, and then brought him down for, or rather brought Roberts down for Hoddle to score from the penalty tonight. Houghton. Here's Stainrod for Queen's Park Rangers. Oh, that's well played by him. Blocked on the edge of the area. That must be a free kick. Steve Perryman, the offender. And danger here for Spurs, with the Rangers restarts, as we mentioned on Saturday, and it was proved to be true. Such an important plus factor for them. Stainrod, the player who went down, is still on the ground. Here's Jimmy Hill.
Well, it's rather interesting that, bearing in mind the advisory committee's recommendations today, whether, if the laws come in next year, you would have given a cynical foul and a penalty kick for that offence there, because there's no doubt that Stainrod had pushed the ball past Perryman. Perryman knew he was beaten and walked into him. It was outside the area, but if the new law comes in next season, then that would be a penalty kick. Interesting, when a similar offence or something like it in the penalty at the other end brought the penalty. But there, young man there, there's Stevie Perryman. He knew what he was doing in that situation. The reward at the moment is a free kick to Rangers. Is it big enough?
Well, we shall soon see. Stainrod is standing fairly ominously next to Curry. He can strike them from here, so too can Flanagan. and Stainrod blusts it against the wall. Whole forest of Tottenham legs in the way. Chip back in again nicely, and Clements is coming a long way here, and he hasn't got it, and here's Micklewhite to shoot, and a good block by Paul Price, with his goalkeeper, frankly, not in the race. Although, whether there was a foul in the penalty area earlier, I suspect there might have been. Steve Perryman is the player hurt for Spurs, but Ray Clements, when that ball was lifted back in by Warren Neal, started to come and see what happens here. Steve Perryman collided with Clements, it would seem, which was why Perryman got hurt. Then Micklewhite, a deflection, but there's a player offside there. Look, the goalkeeper doesn't count there. It has to be two opponents between you and the goal. Clements isn't between him. The free kick was for offside. Waddock. Micklewhite. Flanagan. Hughton. The goal came after 7 minutes. So the second division side asked to come from behind, as they did in the first match. Archibald will chase this. Gillard headed it back to Hoddle, and Hoddle saw the goalkeeper possibly a yard or two out of his ground and tried something very inventive. See where Peter Hooker was. I said a yard or two. In fact, it's 6 yards, isn't it? And Hoddle tried to lob it over him. Archibald. It's an awkward one for Fenwick. There were Spurs players on either side. This is Curry, beaten by Hazard. Here's Archibald. Straight in for Hoddle to head it, but not accurately. Indeed, hardly got a touch. I think Tottenham will look for Hazard here. Bob Hazel trying to cut it out, but he hasn't, and Hazard shoots over. I think, Jimmy, credit to Graham Roberts there for the run which led to the penalty.
Yes, indeed, and it really is the way to break down modern defensive formations, for a player to have the confidence and the courage to make a break from the middle of the field. When you're free, run into the space in front of you and put pressure on the defenders. That's, of course, what Ricky Villa does so well for them, but Graham Roberts took the role up there and did it very well indeed.
Header there by Roberts, in fact, and Bob Hazel covering. Spurs have taken the lead tonight at almost the same time as they did in the replay last year against Manchester City, very early in the game, although, as we all know, that match turned after that and Tottenham found themselves ultimately coming from behind. So a long way to go in this FA Cup final replay. We've been playing now for 13 minutes. It's Price for Tottenham. Being hustled by Steve Archibald. Chris Hughton in the way there. Micklewhite patrolling this right side for Rangers, and a free kick given in their favour. Not from that position though, I fancy. This is Flanagan. It's a nice turn. and a good tackle too by Miller. Now it's Curry for Rangers. Three players waiting in the centre here for QPR. This is Waddock. Ian Gillard moving up on the left, driven rather wide by the pass. Off the head. First of Hazard and then a free kick anyway.
I was just watching young Gary Waddock there when Tony Curry gave away the penalty. Tony was obviously downcast. Gary Waddock, a young player, may be the captain of the future. Tony Curry was the captain tonight. He egged his team on. He shouted at them, come on, let's get back in the game. Tremendous for a young player to show that kind of example.
I know that Terry Venables is an admirer of that sort of character in Gary Waddock, and here's Archibald for Spurs, back to Hoddle. Crooks against Hazel. Archibald against Hazel. Crooks again for Tottenham. Archibald pulled it back. It's going to come to Graham Roberts, who fires over. Tried to keep it down. Came onto it with the side of the foot, but Archibald's cross it was.
Well, that's one. He was on his way to man of the match there. It was a beautiful control from Archibald, and he lost his courage and tried to place it with the side of his foot instead of a meat of the boot drive with the instep, which was really called for. Keeping it down, making sure it hit the target.
It's Curry. And away by Houghton for Spurs. Here's Warren Neal. Nice ball from him too, to Steinrod. Over on the left, Waddock, but Perryman easily intercepting, finding Hoddle. There's Curry for Rangers. Flanagan has got support here from Micklewhite. Chris Houghton. Neal has made a run forward. This is Curry. Swinging it right across. Only as far as Hoddle. And he wants to release that early ball of his, but Neal covered. Here's Galvin. And Tottenham playing in a measured stride here. Archibald. Hoddle. Needs Crooks to pull out wide now. Haven't pulled out quite far enough or back enough to give the pass quite the target it needed. Don't let's underestimate the fighting qualities of Queen's Park Rangers. Bob Hazel. And now Waddock and Curry in some space. Now they've got players ahead here, Rangers, and two to the right. It's Neal. It's Micklewhite now. And again, back with Fenwick. That's driven straight to Hoddle, and that's a nice touch to Archibald, and outside him he's got possibilities. If he can just get a touch on the ball, he couldn't. He had Hazard in support. And now Neal. It's a good-looking ball, and Ray Clements able to cope before John Gregory could close in from the left. Crooks has gone down the right wing, being marked by Gillard. Just Archibald in the centre at present. Here he is, little flick back, Hoddle. Not one of his better passes. White. Possibilities for Steinrod, but Clements again quickly off his line. header was by Flanagan. Micklewhite hesitated, Price didn't, but it was a poor pass from him straight to Flanagan. Gregory could get away on the left. Perryman was there, and so was Price the second time. Gillard on Crooks. Gone in the cup final replay. Spurs lead 1-0, a penalty goal from Glenn Hoddle. Here's Archibald. Good tackle by Waddick. And Tony Curry. And Bob Hazel. Good pass. Warren Neal. Chris Houghton and ball. Gregory and Stainrod have taken up a position on the far side of the area. Bob Hazel is in support. Hazel slipped, actually, as the free kick was being taken, but he hasn't now, and Stainrod's in there, and Paul Miller away to Hoddle. That looked awkward for Tottenham for a moment. Archibald on the right-hand side, Waddick in front of him. Gregory, Hazard. While we were talking about the possibility of the final having to be settled on penalties, we've already seen one penalty tonight, and it separates the two teams for the moment. Hazard, Hoddle, offside on the far side against Perryman. Good backing from the fans of Queen's Park Rangers. And Bob Hazel again showing an inclination to come forward. Something Rangers must do now. That's Neil looking for Flanagan. Good ball. Stainrod's in the centre, unmarked.
That right foot of Flanagan again there. It seems that all the chances fall to him on that foot, and he just lost confidence to have a whack himself. It was a bad angle, wasn't a bad idea. Stainrod was there, but the final pass just gave him no chance whatsoever. Simon Stainrod, unlucky, nothing will come off from him. That wasn't his fault, he was on the spot and didn't get the pass he wanted.
The last Spurs defender was appealing for offside, but it's Stainrod now to Waddick. This is Curry. And Hoddle pressed forward there. Roberts also in the tackle, here's Hoddle. In the way, Hazel. Houghton forward for Hazard. It's an intelligent ball by Graham Roberts to Chris Houghton. And here's Crooks. Hazel sliding in. Roberts to Crooks. Curry nicely away from Roberts and looking about 30 yards to his left to find Stainrod. And Curry's gone down injured. I suspect a late challenge there when the ball had gone on Tony Curry. This is Gregory. Roberts, whose tackle it may have been. Curry's certainly down. Roberts for Spurs. And Crooks didn't run for it. Tony Curry holding his right leg, his shin possibly.
Well, I'm just wondering about that. His right foot was the kicking foot. He seems to be in agony. He's holding his shin. I just wonder whether it could be that original injury. It was a beautiful pass across the field, and he was standing on his other foot. You see, there it is. It was wonderful in the way he beat his man. He did. Now that's his Achilles tendon. I'm quite sure about that. That's a very nasty injury, and I don't think he'll take any part in the game. Something has happened. It wasn't an opponent. There's the magic spray that they use these days. In the old days, we used to have to sit there in pain, but now they've got this magic spray, which seems to do a remarkable job at times. But to see a player collapse like that when he's kicking the ball suggests that there is some injury that's not just a knock. He said he's got, on Saturday, he said there are two Tony Currys, and maybe he'll produce the other one now, the uninjured one, for the rest of the game, because the sub sits down and they appear to have it all under control. But he's certainly seemed crippled with pain for that moment. But it's a good thing he's back in the game. We'd hate to see him go off, because he is a personality. He's one of the players that he showed in that incident that can lift the game with his own personal skill.
That cross was by Chris Hughton for Spurs, looking for Archibald on the far side. Backing him up is Hoddle. There are three in the centre waiting. And a good tackle by Gary Waddock, who played very well indeed in the first match. Indeed, quite a lot of viewers phoned in and supported Gary Waddock in their man of the match vote. I know Jimmy Hill felt that Waddock was one of the outsiders perhaps to win it over the two games. Here's Micklewhite. And Curry beaten by Hoddle's tackle, but following up was Gillard. Price. Touch by Hoddle and a foul this time by Waddock. Gary Waddock only 20, although not the youngest man in the final this time, because Neil is only 19. Here's Hoddle, Crooks, another free kick, this time Ian Gillard coming in quite heavily. Hoddle to take, Miller is forward, and Hazel gets up, and it's hurriedly cleared by Gillard to Micklewhite, a lovely little ball from him to Curry, and Rangers, oh! Hoddle in the way and Crooks closing in, and Fenwick finally manages to clear. Quite a contest between Curry and Hoddle. Gillard. John Gregory then for Rangers. As Micklewhite, Flanagan started a run through the inside right position. Also well forward, Stainrod and Curry. Here's Flanagan. Came off Galvin as far as Micklewhite, who gets down the outside quite nicely. And Stainrod comes in on Clements and knocks him to the ground. And referee Clive White has a word with Simon Stainrod about the challenge. Good deep cross here by Gary Micklewhite from right out there on the touchline. There's the impact between Stainrod and goalkeeper. Has got the Rangers fans singing again. Here's an offside against Archibald. Long ball from Fenwick. Curry. Hoddle. Again, Waddock very close to Glenn Hoddle. Chris Hughton. Galvin, who hasn't been in the game much up to now, out here on the left, possibly because there are two men blocking his way. Here's Curry. Oh, that's a lovely ball from Tony Curry to Warren Neal. Flanagan now. Micklewhite could take this on. good tackle by Miller. And Galvin finds some space, and he's chipped by Warren Neal, just chipping at the ankles. Clive White gives the youngster the benefit there. Here's Crooks. It was Hazard who let the ball run to Roberts. Archibald, who's pulled away to the right. Slips past Gillard. Tottenham have got five players forward. Half an hour gone. Hazard. Perryman is backing up. Spurs throw. So Roberts going across to take the throw. Played quickly to Perryman. Hazard. Archibald, and covering there was Fenwick. The header on was by Steinrod, and it was Miller marking Flanagan, and Clements again imposing his personality on the defender in front of him. Here's Crooks. By the way, we have got a score coming in from the British Championship match at Wrexham, but if you're going to be watching the highlights later on and don't want to know the score, just close your ears for 5 seconds, will you? In the interest of those who do want to know, Wales lead 1-0, a goal by Curtis. Gregory is in here, taken out by Price. Waddock. Curry. Steinrod. Those shots from Steinrod can be deceptive. The one in the 90th minute on Saturday had Clement scrambling a bit, and the Rangers lad certainly felt it was going in. Header to Hoddle, his touch looking for Roberts. In fact, Waddock was a bit late on Hoddle when the ball had gone. Ricky Villar totally engrossed in the match. And here's one of the men in the Spurs midfield, Graham Roberts. Houghton played in for Hazard. He's trying to shake off Hazel, and offside against Archibald, who knocked Fenwick to the ground, but it was all to no avail. There was a flag up here on our near side. Some progress down the Rangers left, but Hoddle was in the way of the pass. Spurs 1, Queen's Park Rangers 0. The goal scored after 7 minutes, a penalty by Glenn Hoddle after Graham Roberts had been brought down by Tony Curry. And here's that man Curry on the ball now for Rangers. Micklewhite. He's having a good match. Came on as substitute for Clive Allen in the first game, and relishing the chance to start the final tonight, Gary Micklewhite. On by Galvin. the Queen's Park Rangers fans making rather more of the noise for the moment, even though their team are a goal down. Will no doubt draw some response from the tunnel end where the Spurs fans are, many of them with yellow flags. Steinrod. Houghton. Looks for Galvin, but it's too long. Ten minutes left in the first half then. Fenwick for Queen's Park Rangers. Steinrod looking for Flanagan. But instead, it's the Tottenham captain, Steve Perryman. Bear in mind, Spurs, a goal ahead here in the League Cup final against Liverpool. A goal ahead on Saturday. They won't want to make the same mistake for a third time. But Rangers trying all they know to find a way back into the match. Was in fairly strongly behind him, so too was Gregory. This is Hoddle, and now it's Hazard. Brooks. A long ball from Fenwick and offside against Flanagan, who's not playing the same role as on Saturday. He was on the left then. Tonight he's more through the centre with Steinrod. Price with the kick for Spurs. Galvin. Hoddle checking it into Crooks. It's back again with Hoddle. Curry trying to close him down. He's found Hazard. It's a header out by Fenwick, as far as Flanagan. Miller quickly onto Steinrod. Price. Ray Clement seeing the chance to get Chris Houghton moving. And a very good challenge indeed by Terry Fenwick. Looks up and wonders about getting Galvin through here. Garth Crooks in support. Archibald is on the far side. Chris Houghton's made a good run forward. Rob Hazel with the challenge. He's had two sterling matches, or one and a half anyway, Bob Hazel, for Queen's Park Rangers. And Crooks, young Neil, Galvin, there's an appeal for a free kick and it's been given offside. Here's Neil. Oh, and Miller let that run to Steinrod, which I don't think he would have done if he could have had his time again. Here's Gillard. Steinrod. Teasing Hazard a bit. But Hazard forced him back. Gillard. And Hazard blocks him. Busy piece of play by the Tottenham midfield man. Steinrod again. Gillard. And Hoddle stepping in. Curry. Waddock. And that was Miller. He was firm where others were being flowery there. And Peter Hooker showing that he can also perform slightly as an outfield player, but the ball went over the line. Brooks, Roberts, and Crooks got a header in. So we have 5 minutes left in the first half, and Spurs lead Queen's Park Rangers by 1-0. And Micklewhite. Tony Galvin getting back to help, and Tottenham certainly taking their time about getting the ball away, but when they did, it was a bright pass from one fullback to the other. Here's Hazard. Perryman's now continued his run down the right wing, and Roberts, well, not that far down the right wing. Roberts apologises. Curry for Rangers then. Oh, under the foot of Gary Waddock. Archibald. But Waddock typically straight back in to make up for his own mistake. Oddle to Archibald. And now Galvin. Again, the two men lined up in front of him, so here comes Houghton to make the extra man for Spurs. Hoddle. Foul by Curry. Well, those two seem to be destined to come face to face in this cup final, one way or the other. Free kick to Spurs. Who was out to block Hoddle's attempted curler. Hoddle says what it was never 10 yards, but the referee seemed happy enough. Here's Perryman. Spurs lined up on the edge of the area here. Curry up with Hoddle, his Archibald. Hoddle again. Houghton. Galvin. And in they go with the feet flying a little bit, John Gregory. And this period of sustained attacking by Tottenham, enforced by two free kicks, this one from rather further out, but it gives Miller the chance to go up. Here's Archibald, and the defender was Gregory, and it was a vital touch too from him to stop Archibald from squeezing in there. Neil, it's a nice piece of play. Micklewhite. Hazard for Spurs. Waddock for Rangers. Free kick. Foul by Miller. Two players never heard the whistle. That was Steinrod and Perryman. But the referee had in fact pulled play back. But he saw what happened afterwards. And he's going to have a word at the back there. And may in fact have booked Miller for the original offence, which was why the free kick was given. Miller's been cautioned for that. So Miller booked, free kick to Rangers. Less than 2 minutes to go in the first half. There will be stoppage time. And Flanagan. Again, and awkward Steinrod. No, the whistle's gone. The whistle's gone. There was a player offside. They're appealing, but the flag was up on the far side. It's no goal. Just keep your eye on what happens. The first shot by Flanagan. The second shot by Flanagan. Look at the player on the... may have been up earlier against the player on the right, but watch now. Steinrod falls. The shot by Micklewhite goes into the net. But the linesman was flagging, the goal has been wiped out. I should say the effort has been wiped out, because when the ball goes in the net and it's disallowed, it's not a goal. Here's Waddick. Micklewhite. Huddle. Archibald. Huddle again. Hilton. This is Galvin with the shot, taken chest high by Peter Hucker from Tony Galvin. Micklewhite. Flanagan. Gillard. Flanagan again. Now, the goal on Saturday came from a long throw by Simon Stainrod. And Roberts this time is the first man to meet the ball. Stainrod lets it run out again, but Bob Hazel is in that dangerous position on the near post. And up he goes, and so does Roberts, a corner. Deep into injury time at the end of the first half, corner to Queen's Park Rangers, who've come strongly in the last 5 minutes. Oh, and Ray Clements at the second attempt, although I fancy there was a foul on him anyway. Goes for half-time, with Spurs leading by Glenn Hoddle's penalty after 7 minutes. Tony Curry gave the penalty away by tripping Roberts from behind, and although Gary Micklewhite, number 9, had the ball in the net just before half-time for Queen's Park Rangers, the goal was disallowed, and the half-time score in the FA Cup final replay is Queen's Park Rangers 0, Tottenham Hotspur 1.
Well, now from a packed Wembley, we're going for the news headlines. Time for our half-time discussion, and sharing the studio with me, Jimmy Hill on the far side, obviously, and Laurie McMenemy. First, Laurie, that disallowed effort by Queen's Park Rangers just before half-time. Let's have a look at it, and do you think the referee was right?
Well, he blew very early, actually, but I wasn't quite sure what it was for. This is one of the well-rehearsed free kicks. Charged down, and then it's whatever happens here. There's a lad in red there who was in an offside position. The linesman probably thought he was there when the ball was kicked, but he buried that. All right, there's nothing happened after that. I can only assume that the man was in an offside position, because he definitely blew early, the referee.
Jimmy, what did you think about it?
Well, here it is coming up again now, and we get a chance to see the moment the ball's played. There it is. Is he offside or not? Oh, there he is. You can see on the left of the screen, coming out from an offside position. It's amazing how linesmen are so accurate in those. You're watching the game generally, and you don't see the odd man standing out, but his job is to look at it. Yeah.
He's in lane,
I think it might have been Terry Fenwick, actually, on the edge of the shot, but it's a bit of an unlucky situation for a side to put one in the net like that and then find a player like that offside.
Yes, it is. And we admire their spirit, I'm sure. They're not giving up. I mean, that moment that Waddock clinched his fist and sort of said, come on, lads. Well,
that was after the penalty incident, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Well, let's have a look at the penalty incident. And Laurie, Jim has talked about this. And I think Jim made the point about Hazel here,
yes,
missing out on his title.
He charges in here, this big Hazel, and he's flung himself at Roberts. And Roberts is not the most skillful player, with due respect, but he dodged that very easily. Saw the gap, went in the box, and Tony Curry had to pull him down. And I think Curry had one or two little words to say to his pal Hazel about that. That was definitely a penalty. And I thought it was interesting that the two key men in the midfield positions, Roberts and Curry, at that stage of the game, Roberts was looking the outstanding player, because shortly afterwards he missed a good chance.
Actually, there's an interesting moment here. I'm not quite sure, but I've got a feeling that the last penalty that Glenn Hoddle took, he missed.
Yes,
and yet he didn't seem to hesitate at all here.
That's helped him. I think he put it down and ran up and just took it, and bang, it went right in the corner. All a goalkeeper can do there is guess, and he guessed wrong a lot.
It's a side foot.
Gentle side foot. A lot of people prefer insteps, but, well, sort of, yeah. I mean, over-gentle, shall we say. But, I mean, it wasn't a drive with the instep.
But he was full of confidence about it, wasn't he?
Yes. Well, if you've got that amount of skill, you can be.
I think that one of the interesting things to me is that QPR tonight are playing four players across the middle. It's a 4-4-2 formation, which requires a lot of running from the front players. He's only got two of them, Flanagan and Stainrod, and they've got to have good support. And I think they lost their way a bit in the middle of that half, but then that disallowed goal just before half-time seemed to lift everyone, and they had support coming from everywhere, Jim. And I think that it's a great time to score, but if you're not going to score, it's a good time to have one disallowed even.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, there's been massive interest in our phone-in with people for the Man of the Match. There was a tremendous response on Saturday. Although we told them not to ring the number today until the second half, apparently they've been ringing through the first half. Now, Peter Hucker was the Man of the Match last Saturday, yeah, by voting over 2-1, apparently, by the public. He's got a big lead because we carry it on. Now, looking at this first half, who would you pick out for the viewers' thoughts this time?
Difficult, really, isn't it?
It is, isn't
at
it?
This stage, it could have been Roberts. He could have emerged as a challenger, yeah, if he'd only buried that chance that he had, but he took that with the side of his foot and scooped it over the top, so that didn't come off. I like Stevie Perryman, I must say that. I've liked him in both games. He's a fantastic player to have in your side. He's full of experience, but there was one occasion where he was running with Stainrod and he overtook him. So yeah, he's old, but he's still quicker than most of the other players on the field.
He's going to have to be a bit quick to catch Hucker, though, after that first match performance, isn't he? Laurie, sure. What about you?
Well, I would agree there that Stevie Perryman, he's not only doing well from his fullback point of view, but from a captain's point of view. Tottenham seem to be playing a nice, patient game tonight. On Saturday, for me, they played a lot of long passes, which is not like them. Yeah. Tonight, he is making sure that they don't panic. I can't see them breaking away too much from that formation second half, and he is doing a vital job keeping them there. But on the other side, although I've got to mention the gingerhead lad again, yeah, Gary Waddick, who seems to be in the thick of everything, and by hell, when he tackles, I think they get up knowing that they've had a good hard tackle on them.
A one-liner. Any doubts who's going to win, Jim? For you, it's...
I admire Rangers' spirit enormously.
They
the keep battling. Spurs weren't so good in the second half on Saturday. Maybe Rangers will have the stamina, but I still think Spurs.
Well, I think Spurs, because yeah, Spirit's never won anything yet, I don't think, you know. But, okay, well, it's ability that's going to win this one, I think.
Thanks very much, Emmanuel. Two very definite votes there for Spurs. But you, of course, can still vote for the Man of the Match. I'll give you the number in a moment. Let's just have a look outside now at the scene, and we can look at it from the airship, the Goodyear airship, above the Wembley Stadium. There's over 90,000 in the stadium, and they're looking down there on the combined bands of the Guards Division entertaining the crowd. Just before we go to listen to the music and watch the marching, this is the phone number if you want to nominate a Man of the Match. Just ring through with a name and your name. That's all we need, and you can start ringing about 15 minutes from the end of the match. 01 if you're outside London, 811-8055. I'll repeat that, 01 outside London, 811-8055. And this lovely silver trophy will be presented to the person you choose as the Man of the Match immediately after the match. All right, out we go again then to concentrate on the marching and playing of the combined bands of the Guards Division.
So the two teams coming out for the second half of this FA Cup final replay. Those two gentlemen coming out behind Clive Allen as he goes on his crutches, two of the psychiatrists who've been working with Spurs this season in the grey suits there. It's an interesting experiment Keith Birkinshaw has tried, and Clive White comes out. I don't want to for one moment contradict our experts. Indeed, I agree there was a player offside on that replay, although I just wondered, seeing it again at half-time while they were talking, whether Clive White might also have spotted a little push on Paul Miller, maybe by Steinrod. So possibly a combination of reasons why the officials didn't give a goal, although certainly Fenwick number two was the player in the offside position. But all that's history now. Spurs lead 1-0. Ricky Villar, whose glory night this was last year, coming out with Keith Birkinshaw. And he's certainly enjoyed the cup final, Gary Waddock, and how well he's been playing. So Glenn Hoddle's penalty goal dividing the two sides, and when Tottenham last won the cup 2 years running, 61 and 62, Danny Blanchflower scored from a penalty against Burnley. And as I said at the time, we've never seen a penalty missed in an FA Cup final at Wembley. There was one missed prior to that, but Spurs lead here tonight 1-0. Rangers substitute tonight, by the way, is Steve Burke, an orthodox outside left, so they do have that alternative if they want to change the formation. Here's Gillard. And now it's Curry, with Neil to the right. Flanagan. Michael White, a man whose effort was disallowed. Hazel. Oh. Certainly come forward with effect. Steinrod. But he hasn't been quite so effective. Taken every chance to go raiding upfield, Bob Hazel. Front. John Gregory's made a searching run in the inside right position. Chris Hughton covering him. Price. And it was Crooks who was fouled by Fenwick. With the kick, Archibald coming in from this side to get the header in. Looks as though Hooker's collided with the post at some stage, doesn't it? That's rather loose from Tony Curry. Is Crooks. Curry in though. Perryman. And they were almost caught him there in possession, Rangers. Here's Gillard. And Hazard for Tottenham. This is the sort of space that Galvin enjoys. He can run at the fullback here. although Gregory is supporting Neil. Crooks, Galvin goes for a possible return and Neil slides in. Curry. Oh, the mistake was by Roberts. Can Curry capitalise? He's found Micklewhite, who's gone past Houghton and has resisted the other challenge, and Stainrod is in there, and Clements did just enough coming out to put Stainrod off. Very good play here by Gary Micklewhite. Look at the way he resisted the two challenges. Now then, Stainrod is coming in. There goes Clements, off Stainrod's head, over the bar. But Ray Clements was injured in the collision, but knew he'd done enough. Now, Graham Roberts will not be pleased with the way he gave the ball to Tony Curry. A sign that Spurs must keep their concentration if they want to keep their lead. Up goes Gregory. Just a reminder that we do have extra time should the scores be level at the end of 90 minutes before we would need to go into a penalty sequence. It's all assuming that Queen's Park Rangers equalise. Here's Hazel. Hazard. Roberts. Crooks. Still Rangers biting the tackle, keep their morale high. And Curry, a lovely pass forward there to John Gregory. It was Micklewhite who ran into Houghton but kept possession. That's a good turn. Shaking off Hoddle as well. There's Gillard. Archibald trying to get that goal side, and in doing so used his arms. Case of obstruction there, really. Quickly taken to Curry. Gregory is the man at the back post. And that's the area that Queen's Park Rangers felt they exploited on Saturday, certainly on the goal they did, but at other times as well, they felt that maybe Spurs are a little weak in that area when the ball's in the air. Crowd raising the volume. The attendance, by the way, tonight officially given as 90,000, but the Wembley capacity for evening games is 92. Here's Perryman for Spurs. Hazard's begun a run. Hoddle. Now Hazard. Back again to Hoddle. Offside against Garth Crooks. A well-known Wembley scene. The replay of the 101st FA Cup final. Curry. Gregory's gone through the centre. Here's Stainrod. And Flanagan is coming in, and Clements gets his fist to the ball. Only as far as Curry, though. Micklewhite putting it back in for Tony Curry. Ray Clements certainly having more to do tonight than he did on Saturday. Galvin. Micklewhite playing really well for Queen's Park Rangers. That's Gregory's header. That's a foul by Waddock on Tony Galvin. Here's Hazard.
It's true, John. Young Gary Micklewright has played really well tonight, and he made that marvellous chance for Stainrod there, Simon Stainrod. I feel so sorry for him. Nothing's really come off for him in the two games, but that beautiful little chip left him perfectly placed, and Clements got the end of his knuckles to it just to pop it against his forehead and get it over the top. He's played brilliantly around second division grounds, but he's yet to prove his worth at this level.
But here he is, Simon Stainrod with the cross. Flanagan is going up this time with Clements, and he was... This is Gregory, and it's Miller and Perryman away. Clements challenged fiercely by two opponents, couldn't collect that one. Gregory got the ball back in, a timely clearance by Miller, and then Perryman. Corner to Rangers. In they come, Gregory notably, Hazel at the far side, this is Fenwick. Oh, he went down, is it a penalty? No, the linesman flagged, Fenwick seemed to be the player who was impeded. I thought I saw a flag go up there. I think Rangers might have a case for a penalty, it's not been given. This is Galvin. Well, there's a talking point. Brooks. That was a let-off for Tottenham, and here's Houghton. Or rather, here's Hooker. And they're still wondering about that incident in the penalty area. It may have been that the flag was actually being waved from side to side to indicate the linesman didn't think it was a foul. One has to be aware of that. Stainrod. Clements is being called upon more and more as Rangers press home a territorial advantage and are having a good spell early in the second half. Archibald. Brooks. To help Gillard. Stainrod. So Queen's Park Rangers having had the ball in the net and then having it disallowed, then a penalty appeal turned down. Not much is going their way, but here's Crooks for Spurs. Galvin. And Roberts is nearly in here. Archibald's having a go at it. Archibald! Fine save by Hooker. He seems destined to deny Archibald at every strike. Fine reactions from Archibald's shot. It was an instant drive here by Steve Archibald with the right foot and an instant save. Waddock. Free kick. Perryman. Micklewhite. Gregory trying to turn it on. Here's Houghton. Stirring start to the second half by Rangers, but here's Honnell trying to find Crooks. Well, my feeling was that Terry Mitchell with the yellow flag might have been flagging to say no penalty. Clive White may have looked across. Just watch what happens here in the penalty area and keep your eye on number two, Terry Fenwick. He goes in for the ball there. The tackle is by Crooks. Did he trip him? Well, he went down. Clive White looked across.
and seemed to think there was a dive, and it may be the linesman's flag just said he agreed. Archibald. Perryman. It's Crooks for Tottenham. This is Gregory. And there could be something on here for Rangers. It's Stainrod with two coming in from the far side. And there's a deflection on that. Splendid save. Stainrod shot, a slight deflection. Clements equal to it. Just caught the second Tottenham player, Clements, going to his left. A fine sustained spell here by the second division side, really examining Tottenham. Terry Venables must know this could be the moment. Gregory didn't quite meet it. What it did! Oh, and that's another brilliant save, and it's not over yet. Flanagan puts it back, and it's put wide of the goal by Miller. Waddock hit it, and Clements was even more brilliant there. There was a Rangers player in his way, number nine. Look at that, over his head. Great stop. Gregory's in there. Away by Houghton, partially. That was Neil, a good little ball back to Curry, and they're still queuing up in the centre. Gregory heads it down. And Spurs, for the moment, just glad to survive. Free kick again to Queen's Park Rangers. It's all with the second division team for the moment. An hour of the match gone, they trail 1-0. But goodness me, they're not playing like a second division side here. Spurs are in trouble. Flanagan up is Bob Hazel. Hoddle. Oh, Archibald could put Crooks through. He could get Crooks offside, is he? Yes. Must be offside, Garth Crooks. The pass needed to come just a second earlier. From Tottenham's point of view, that was. Out.
I was just looking at the expression on Garth Crook's face there. He knew that he was offside, and he knew that Archibald had not delivered the ball early enough for him. He wasn't arguing at the linesman, he wasn't annoyed at him. He just wished that Steve Archibald, who's done much better than Saturday in general tonight, had woken up a fraction earlier and given Crooks that ball. His control's been precise tonight, Archibald. He hit that ball very well in limited time and has had a much sharper game. But he should have let that one go early, because it would have created an open goal situation.
Gregory. And that's the risk that Rangers run, obviously, in pushing forward, searching for the equaliser. They know that if they leave themselves short in defence, Spurs could catch them with that quick combination of Archibald and Crooks. It's a chance they've got to take as they try to cancel out Tottenham's lead. Flanagan started a run here, and so has Stainrod. Well, Spurs have been pleased for the calming influence of Ray Clements this last quarter of an hour. More of that later. This is Hazard. And there's one for Archibald and Crooks to chase. Bob Hazel, the defender, and foul by Archibald. Down there, I would imagine. There's Crooks. Goal! Goal! Goal!
Spurs need that massed support from behind the right-hand goal. Here's Crooks. Ball coming off Terry Fenwick. Good block. Steve Archibald having to get back and help defend on the right-hand side for Tottenham. This is Perriman. And Spurs have lost their rhythm. It's been shaken out of them a bit by Rangers. Here's Archibald. And shaken out by snappy challenges like that as Rangers break up the play again. They'll be remembered for this opening period in the second half, Queen's Park Rangers, among other things. Here's Stainrod, referee said play on to Curry, you had possession. Gregory is closing in, Flanagan's there as well. That's awkward, he's at the bar. My goodness me, they've exposed the far post again, John Gregory. Clements was beaten there. The ball swung beautifully across. And Gregory got the, by Stainrod that was. And Gregory coming in behind, got a delicate little side foot touch, and look at that, off the bar. How unlucky can they be? It's Rangers' second half here. Curry, Gregory, Micklewhite. Oh, Tottenham have just got to try and get two passes together now. They've failed to do it because Rangers have played so well in the last 15 minutes particularly. John Gregory who hit the bar. We're 20 minutes into the second half and I wouldn't be surprised to see Tottenham make a substitution. Their game seems to me to have lost its shape. Houghton. Galvin trying to get through on the left. Flanagan. Curry's pass, they both hesitated there, Perriman and Gillard, and Perriman has got Archibald away. Now there are three in the centre, Hoddle and Galvin and Crooks, but still Archibald. It's Hazard. It's Roberts now. They're playing the offside of Queen's Park Rangers. Can Tottenham exploit it? Perriman. Well, not like that, they can't. And the Tottenham substitution. As we watch John Gregory's effort again here from behind the goal, you'll get an interesting angle on it now. It's beautifully placed, isn't it? Whether it was meant to be a cross or a shot, you can debate, but it's hit the bar. Meantime, Spurs are making a substitution. Mick Hazard is the man going off, but he's in fact been waved back there. You can see Gary Brooke waiting. The ball's back in play. So it looks like the substitution we saw on Saturday. There's Perriman for Spurs. Hoddle touched the ball through. Crooks chasing, so is Hazard. Bob Hazel glad to get the ball out. And now they can make the substitution. Tottenham. So Mick Hazard, again the man brought off, as he was in the League Cup final and twice in the FA Cup final now. And Gary Brooke will come on. For the third time in four FA Cup finals. 23 minutes left. Galvin. Now Roberts. Halfway through the second half, Tottenham Hotspur 1, Queen's Park Rangers 0, but it's been a second half in which Rangers' tails have been up and Tottenham have been under severe strain. And there's still a lot of time left. Micklewhite for Rangers. think there'll be a few votes for Gary Micklewhite tonight as a contender for man of the match. Here's Curry, Micklewhite again. Bob Hazel, Micklewhite. Rangers calling the tune. Curry. Stainrod in the inside left position, Clements coming. Ray Clements tonight showing what goalkeeping is all about when you have to come off your line. Perryman to Hoddle. Tony Galvin, that's the best pass that Tottenham have produced for quite some time. Houghton. Brooke, the substitute. That's Brooke's shot and Hucker saw it all the way. Taking every chance still to make the extra man for Rangers. They're looking for Fenwick on the far post, and it needed a header by Paul Price. It's a corner. Gregory is up there. Waddock is back in with it. Offside, offside. Spurs cleared their lines quickly there.
There's the linesman who had his flag up, and my view is that Clive White probably saved him from making a mistake. He's refereed the game beautifully tonight. He's allowed it to flow. He's allowed it to be a game of football, not stopped it unless he had to. And my view of that incident when the linesman had his flag up for a penalty is that Clive White saved him from making what I think would have been a bad decision.
Certainly it's one incident that QPR will be debating at the end of the match, whichever way it goes. That's Archibald. There's Hoddle. Oof, the tackles are coming in thick and fast now, but it's a tribute to Rangers, the way they've won the ball so often in that important midfield area. Side. Flag was up straight away. If you're thinking now of phoning in with your man of the match nomination, just bear in mind the telephone number, 01 if you're outside London, 811-8055 if you want to register a vote for man of the match. And there are quite a few contenders at the moment, very much on the Rangers side, I would imagine. This is Curry. Flanagan. Fenwick. Gregory's header. Stainrod's in there. That was also very dangerous. And Glenn Hoddle might get Spurs going. The ball to Archibald. Oh, what a good header by Bob Hazel. Well, you'd never think that on this second half performance that we were watching a first division side against a second division team, would you? Miller sliding in. Curry with the long ball. Waddock. Gillard. Stainrod. And Gary Brooke just looking for an outlet. Again, Bob Hazel cuts it out. Wasn't intentional, the handball, says Clive White. Let's play go. Stainrod. Just wonder whether Spurs, under this sort of concerted attack by Queen's Park Rangers, are beginning to feel tired mentally as well as physically. Bob Hazel's forward again. Brooks. Archibald just glad to get the ball back to his goalkeeper, although under one or two of the proposed changes of laws that Jimmy Hill's been discussing, I know that the long back pass could be wiped out. Not sure whether he would excuse Steve Archibald in that position or not. Perriman. Brooke. Warren Neal playing soundly at right back. Brooke getting in on Curry there. 15 minutes to go here at Wembley. 15 minutes, that is, if Spurs keep this lead. Rangers still trying to force extra time. 1-0, the advantage to Tottenham. If you want to know what's happening in the British Championship match, I will give the score. So if you don't want to know, please don't listen for the next 2 or 3 seconds. Wales lead Northern Ireland 3-0. Now, one of the questions now is whether or not Queen's Park Rangers use their substitute, Steve Burke. Absolutely dominated the second half. Can they sustain it, I wonder, or will Tottenham now have another say? Archibald takes the throw. Galvin. Archibald. Oof, it was an offside anyway, the flag was up. And Price didn't make that, and Tony Curry might get Micklewhite away. Stainrod is coming in from this side. Flanagan also trying to get forward. And Clement had to fingertip the ball away. With the clearance for Spurs, and it was knocked back there by Neal out to Curry. Gregory in the centre, so is Hazel, and Hazel, oh, blocked by Miller. That's three times Paul Miller has made last-ditch clearances from almost on his own goal line. Just watch the way Curry drive the ball back, and there was Miller on Hazel. Well played, Miller, but still Rangers press. And Gregory and Hazel coming in together. Gregory got a touch. And Clement's throw is just too long for Gary Brooke. It's brought all the pressure back on top. And look at this. Curry. Micklewhite. Pursuited in trouble against Curry. Rangers appeal again. They, one or two of them, have run to Clive White. It looked to me like six of one and a half a dozen of the other. The referee says, well, there was a backing in. He's been waved on. Jimmy Hill.
I think it was 6-1 and 6-0 there, John. Tony Curry hadn't quite got it, and he did his best with a dramatic roll around there, but it wasn't enough to convince Clive White. He's cool, he loves refereeing, and that's why he gets so many decisions right, even though they may look very difficult from an amateur's point of view. But it's interesting, on Saturday, Spurs faded in the second half. They couldn't kill Rangers off, and it looks as if their season is taking its toll of them physically in this second half too. But can they hang on to that one goal? Hazel. Just over 11 minutes on the watch. Spurs, tenuous 1-0 lead. Crooks. Galvin. Offside against Flanagan, the man furthest in. Well, tiredness was a word Jimmy Hill used, and it certainly seems to reflect the way Tony Galvin's looking at the moment. And Spurs have got no more cards to play, they've got their substitute on. And Keith Birkinshaw's got some anxious minutes to live through yet. Ricky Villa, the back of the Spurs bench. Perryman. Crooks. Perryman again. Brook. Hoddle's touch, but it was asking too much of Brook, and it was broken up by Fenwick. Flanagan that lost his balance, and Roberts who turned the ball back. Archibald and Gillard doing a bit of holding, and the ball came off Waddock for a Tottenham throw. Archibald. Crooks, Hoddle, Crooks, Archibald, good block by Bob Hazel, Archibald again, Gary Brook driving well wide. I think Bob Hazel may have been slightly winded there, but it was certainly an important body in the way for QPR. Curry still driving them forward. Perryman. Flanagan on to Gregory. Fenwick spraying it out. To go, Crooks for Spurs. Perryman, and that's Hoddle, and that's Archibald, and Archibald and Perryman going together. Marvellous goalkeeping by Hooker, so brave, and good blocking earlier by the Rangers defender in front of him too, which prevented Archibald's shot going in. Micklewhite. Flanagan the target now, and Perryman covering for Tottenham. He can't go that way. Steinrod's there. Crooks. Roberts. Archibald. Tony Galvin's offside. And Queen's Park Rangers about to throw their substitute into the match. Steve Burke has come to the line.
And Gary Micklewhite, who must have run his legs off, played so well, he goes off. Now, Steve Burt normally is an outside left. Let's just see if he comes onto this wing. He's got just over 6 minutes to make an impact as Rangers strive to save the FA Cup final. Curry on the ball, looking for Stainrod. That was Miller. That was Houghton. And Roberts. Gary Brooke. Roberts has continued his run and Crooks is on this side, but that's much too strong from Brooke. Well, this was the dangerous time for Tottenham on Saturday. In extra time, admittedly, but the last few minutes, which has seen their downfall in the League Cup final as well. And their own fans so conscious of that. Hoddle. He went down fairly heavily, but Waddock has helped him up. It's been some good sportsmanship amid all the tension. Miller's clapping his hands, saying to Spurs, let's rouse ourselves for one last bid to resist Rangers. And take some resisting they have in this second half. Archibald. Houghton. Crooks is offside. Bob Hazel. A real inspiration tonight to Queen's Park Rangers. Burke. Gillard. Flanagan goes in with Price, Stainrod runs on, foiled by Houghton. Galvin, Archibald. Here comes Fenwick, free kick. Fenwick is the player injured. Steve Archibald playing a little bit of gamesmanship with Tony Curry. But they've got to keep their concentration now, Tottenham. This could be a telling time.
Just wondering about the man of the match award, John. It's quite a poser, I would think, for those watching at home. If it was a Spurs player, I suppose you'd have to say on the two games, Stevie Perriman, who's given an immaculate performance. And he gave that lovely deft little ball which created that last opportunity there into Glenn Hoddle. Hoddle might have scored himself, but he backheeled it. It just didn't go home. But for Rangers, well, you can take the pick of the bunch. Even Bob Hazel, who's in the market, up for sale. It could be him.
Free kick then to Queen's Park Rangers to be taken by Tony Curry. Fenwick got it back in. Hazel is there. It came out to Warren Neal. Curry. And Fenwick's in there again. He thought he might have been impeded. Oh, look at the break. It's three against one. Gary Brooke, can he play it right this time? Oh, he's gone alone. Well, in far be it from me up here to criticise, but he had Crooks to his right and Archibald to his left. Hoddle. Waddock, Miller. Well, that could have killed Rangers off if he'd released the ball. Curry. Gillard. 2.5 minutes we make it of normal time. Hazel. Curry. What a good tackle by Paul Miller. It's been mostly about Rangers in the second half, but Paul Miller, who at times this season has had to fight to keep his position in the Tottenham team, if there's a hero in their defence, it's him. Apart from Ray Clements, who's kept the others calm as well as keeping goal in exemplary fashion.
Gary Brooke for Tottenham, 2 minutes on the watch. Archibald, oh, offside. Nail-biting time for Tottenham. Steve Archibald has clearly asked Clive White how long he's got on his watch. Waddock. Not giving Burke too much hope with that. Clive White has looked across at both linesmen. Burke. Gillard. It's Burke with the throw. Curry. We're in the last minute, I make it. And still Rangers won't relent. Steinrod. Gary Brooke trying to get the tackle in and Steinrod turns in. He turned two of them there and in the end Tottenham were glad to see Perryman step in. Archibald's away, put there by Hoddle. Can he make sure this time? Archibald! He's at the post. An agonising cup final for him. That came in the last few seconds. It's stoppage time. Any moment now. Perryman for Spurs. Spurs are now surely within seconds of retaining the FA Cup. It's a matter of how much time Clive White adds on. Brooks. It's a free kick. A foul by Perryman on Waddock. Archibald with that opportunity to make it 2-0. At last he beat Hucker, but he didn't beat the post. And Curry takes the free kick. Hazel on, harmlessly this time. Well, the stadium humming now as the Spurs fans look again anxiously at their watches. They know, as Glenn Hoddle knows, that we're in time being added on by the referee for stoppages. And there it is! Tottenham Hotspur have won the FA Cup 2 years running, but Hoddle's congratulations of Waddock say it all. Ray Clements is relieved because Queen's Park Rangers put up a wonderful fight in the second half here, and Tottenham hung on for dear life, and they hung on successfully. Well, what a match Gary Waddock had for Rangers. Glenn Hoddle's penalty, the deciding goal. Peter Hucker, it had to be a penalty to beat him in the end. Keith Birkinshaw's team finish up with a trophy after all. Ricky Villar looks on with the other Tottenham reserves. And what an anxious time they had on the bench in that second half when Queen's Park Rangers did their club and the second division in general proud. Emotional scenes now. The relief for Tottenham must be enormous. For Terry Venables, there has to be a great deal of praise for him and his team. They've made a very, very good match of tonight's replay. They showed character in both games, but tonight they dictated play for much of the second half. Alan Harris, the assistant there to Terry Venables, having a word with disconsolate players. But they've no reason to feel anything other than proud. Spurs have made it 7 FA Cup wins out of 7. They've equaled Aston Villa's record of 7 FA Cup triumphs. But Spurs have never lost in a final. And Steve Perryman has an honour now which has only gone to 2 men previously this century. Joe Harvey of Newcastle and Danny Blanchflower of Tottenham did this. Went up to receive the cup 2 years running. Ray Clements gets a winner's medal in his first season at Tottenham. and up that specially widened gangway where the crowd can't quite reach them now come the Tottenham team and the footballer of the year, Steve Perryman, goes forward to receive the FA Cup from His Royal Highness the Duke of Kent. The end of a very long Tottenham season, but that's what came at the end. Graham Roberts there with the cap. His run produced the penalty, which produced the goal. Seven times now, Spurs have won the FA Cup. Assortment of caps being worn. Paul Miller there, what a second half he had. It was desperate defence, but he held out. Archibald, who hit the post in the last minute. Clements, who was a tremendous influence. Price, an FA Cup winner's medal in his first season at Spurs. And now, as Chris Hughton wearing a Queen's Park Rangers shirt, but the men who wore them with such endeavour and such ability for the second division. Tony Curry leads his team up. Jim Gregory, I should imagine, a very happy chairman tonight, even in defeat. Gary Waddock, many people's vote, surely is the man of the match. Steve Burke, the sub, hardly had time to make an impact. Gregory hit the bar. Stainrod bothered Tottenham as well. And so too, while he was on, did Mickle White. Bob Hazel, tremendous at the back and when he came forward, and Ian Gillard ends a long career at Queen's Park Rangers with a loser's medal. Keith Birkinshaw, who must have wondered at times whether Tottenham would ever retrieve their touch in the second half, but the signs of tiredness are there for all to see now. This means that Tottenham Hotspur go into the European Cup Winners' Cup again. It also means, for the record, and I'm sure it'll be mentioned anyway, that Southampton take the other UEFA Cup place. Ricky Villar, the hero a year ago, watching there with Mark Falco, but the hero this year for many, many people was the Queen's Park Rangers goalkeeper, Peter Hucker. In the end, beaten by a penalty. Rangers, bear in mind, had to make the changes. Clive Allen on crutches, his ankle heavily strapped, missed the second match. So did Glenn Roeder. But how well their replacements performed. Spurs, who played 66 matches this season and lost only 13. So in the end, I suppose you can say that the FA Cup final nobody wanted settled by penalties was in fact determined by a penalty. Peter Shreves and Johnny Wallace in the back row there, part of the Tottenham staff. Mike Varney as well, the physiotherapist, enjoying the moment. Keith Birkinshaw. And no wonder they're getting a good round of applause. Tony Curry, who led the team with so much spirit and had the misfortune to give away the penalty. Well, they'll look back, Queen's Park Rangers, on the ball being in the Tottenham net and the goal being disallowed. On a penalty appeal when Fenwick thought he was fouled, on Gregory's shot that hit the bar. But in the end, as I think one of the Aston Villa players said last night, Jimmy Rimmer, it's winning that counts if you're a professional footballer, and Spurs have won. And the big Argentine has received a generous reception from the Wembley crowd tonight, and he also receives a Tottenham scarf.
keep voting for your man of the match, by the way. The lines are still open. Gillard, who now has a free transfer from Queen's Park Rangers. And Glenn Hoddle, scorer of the only goal of the replay. It was in fact his 15th of the season. Six of them have been penalties. Now he'll be turning his attention towards the World Cup and England's prospects in Spain. Queen's Park Rangers crowd giving their team a marvellous send-off. There are some fans who've broken the security cordon, which is a shame, but generally speaking, it's an orderly scene. Steve Perryman, over 660 matches for Tottenham, and the banner was right. They'd won it six times out of six, and now they've made it seven. They go now to the end where the Spurs fans are congregated. And there'll be some dancing and singing again tonight in Tottenham High Road. The £2 million final. The fans have dug deep into their pockets. Indeed, that goes for Tottenham supporters the whole season, the places they've been in Europe and in domestic cup matches and following their team in the league. And for those people, there was a reward right at the end of the lane. So the Wembley floodlights beat down as Spurs take the FA Cup in a replay for the second year running. A final score in the Cockney Cup final of 1982 of second division Queen's Park Rangers 0, Tottenham Hotspur 1. And now down in the interview room, Barry Davis.
Well, with me, a man who must look back on his team's performance with considerable pride, even though they lost, the Queen's Park Rangers manager, Terry Venables.
Yes.
You'd agree with that, no doubt.
Very much so. I'm very proud of all of them, yes.
Tough luck?
I thought so. I thought we were a better side on the night, and I think they would agree with that as well. I think they do agree with that, and I'd like to thank our supporters. I thought they were absolutely magnificent, and everybody representing the club, first class.
Terry, I'm going to ask you to do the honours of making the presentation for the man of the match, which, remember, is over the two matches. I don't think there's any doubt who the recipient should be. He's your goalkeeper standing on your left, Peter Hucker.
Congratulations, Peter. Thanks. Thoroughly deserved it.
Cheers.
Well done, sir. You always wear it?
Peter, let's have a... He wants his colleagues to see. Let's he wanted to swap it. Let's have that belt. He's trying very hard here. If you can't just see, he's trying very hard to swap the award, which he thoroughly deserved, for the FA Cup. But Chris Houghton, who's keeping hold of it, is making quite sure that he doesn't. Peter, just a comment on the two matches overall. Chris, don't go away.
Well, I was really pleased to do well in the games. It's very difficult coming into games like that. The difficult games to play, and I'm just really a bit sorry for the crowd. Like, they've been marvellous, supported us really well. I think they deserve a little bit better.
Tremendous stop from Steve Archibald tonight.
I'm his bogeyman.
Well, football is about winners and losers. Tough luck to Terry Fenwick, but if I can invite Graham Roberts, Glenn Hoddle and Chris Houghton to join me. Graham, your run that produced the decisive moment.
Yes, I picked the ball up and I went past one defender and I just see a gap, so I just knocked the ball and Bob Hazel, I think it was, he went to slide tackle me and he missed the ball. So I felt I had to go all the way, so I just kept running and running. And I think it was Terry Curry just caught my ankles as I was going to kick the ball. So yeah,
he seemed to me to have something of a rush of blood on the head, Hazel. Glenn, you didn't take too much time over putting it away, did
well,
you?
Well, once Graham went down and the referee gave it, my first thought was get it in the back of the net. The last one I took against Shilts, I missed at Forest in the league, so I was a little bit worried.
Which corner did you put it? I didn't watch.
You didn't watch?
Oh, no.
Thanks very much, Chris.
Well, a little ironic, Glenn, that in the end it was decided by a penalty.
Yes, it was. It's a shame, but, you know, it was a good game first half, we felt, for us, and give Queen's Park Rangers their due. They came out of second half and they produced a great sort of performance second half, and it was end-to-end stuff. I mean, they could have had sort of three goals and we could have had three second half, so it was good entertaining stuff, I felt.
Yes, and I think feelings of relief as much as elation, but congratulations on winning it on what was your 6-6 match of the season.
Thank you.
Well, watching that with amusement too and enjoyment, Laurie McMenemy and Jimmy Hill. And a second half to remember. And Jimmy, your half-time forecast wasn't bad, was it? Rangers with spirit, and they produced it.
It wasn't only the spirit, it's the fact that Spurs have had a tough season. I'm afraid people will never understand that footballers sometimes run out of energy, like a racehorse, and they were feeling their season in the second half tonight and on Saturday. That's why I always gave Rangers a sneaking chance, but at the end of the day, I can't say I'm glad that Spurs won it, because I think Rangers were unlucky. That John Gregory lob, which he did mean, which hit the bar, I thought was the tragedy of the night.
I'll tell you something you don't know. Laurie, who needed Spurs to win to get into Europe with Southampton, in the end was cheering Rangers because you enjoyed their fight back, didn't you?
Well, that's right. It was unfair to ask me to comment on this game tonight. It was sheer purgatory the second half. I was heading balls in, I was keeping them off the line. But I must say, Terry Venables, full marks. I asked the commissioner in the lift, what was the next occasion here? He said, the Pope's here on Saturday. And I'll tell you, there's only the Holy Father that could follow that.
Yeah, and in fact, it means you're going to Europe.
Yes.
Thanks very much. Well, it really was a tremendous finish to that match. The result, of course, Spurs, for the second time in 20 years, retain the cup, which is a unique performance. And now from us all here at Wembley, good night.
On BBC Two in a moment, Brass Tacks reports with a film reconstruction compiled from the diary of a convicted murderer about his experiences during 5.5 years in solitary confinement. Here on One in 30 Minutes, Ronnie Corbett stars as Timothy Lumsden in Sorry, and this week our little hero falls for a nubile bridesmaid called Liz.